In this video, I will import sequencer curve files in a new empty database. I press the import button in the toolbar, and under fingerprint type data, I choose the option import curves. In the first step, I need to browse for the curve files. I select my files and press the open button. All files are displayed in the input dialog. In the next dialog, the two default import templates are listed. The first import template will parse entry information from the file names. The second import template will not only parse entry key information from the file names, but also pool information. In the present dataset, only key information is provided in the file names of the curve files. Pressing the preview button gives an idea of how the data will be parsed. The key names could be shorter since a lot of information is not informative. I can adjust this by clicking the edit button. I select the row in the grid that is linked to the key field. I show the advanced options and go to edit parsing. From the preview, I can see that not the complete file name should be linked to the key field, but only the part that appears between the third and fourth underscore. I specify this parsing string. And press the preview button to verify the adjustment. I go back to the general preview and see that all keys are now parsed correctly. In the next step, I need to select the dyes that should be imported and indicate which dye is used as reference dye. Default, all dyes are checked and will be imported. I will uncheck the Joe and Ned channels since these channels do not contain any signal in my dataset. In my example dataset, the rocks channel contains the size standard, so I make sure rocks is selected as reference dye. Next, I choose to link the data to the entries by means of the key field and press finish. I have no fingerprint type experiments present yet in this database, so the import wizard will create a new experiment. I specify a name and confirm the creation of the new experiment in my database. For each imported dye, a fingerprint type experiment needs to be present in the database. The name of these fingerprint types is composed of the base fingerprint type name, followed by the name of the dye. Since these fingerprints are not yet present in my database, I confirm the creation of the missing fingerprints. The import routine checks if the keys are already present in the database, and if not, new entries will be created. Enabling this checkbox will automatically import the data in the curve preprocessing window. BioNumerics now splits the curve files into separate fingerprint files per imported dye. The individual lanes are assigned to their appropriate fingerprint type and corresponding entry. The fingerprint preprocessing curve window opens and all channels are loaded and displayed. First, I will change the OD range for my curves. I select File, Curve Processing Settings, and change the OD range to 12-bit. Clicking on the eye icon next to a channel hides the channel from the view. I'll do this for the data channel. So now only the reference channel is visible. I can zoom in or out on the curves with the zoom sliders on the sides or on top. In the first step, peaks need to be defined in the reference die. This is done with Bands, Search Reference Bands. I will use these settings and press OK. All bands that fall within the specified criteria are marked with a solid line at the band's position. To define a reference system, I need to select a suitable lane and select References, Define Size Standard. The GeneScan 500 ROC standard was used as reference in this dataset, so I select this standard from the list, select Pattern Match, and press OK. The bands of the GeneScan 500 ROCs reference system are matched with the bands in the reference lanes. I will save the changes done so far. To normalize the complete run at once, I press this button and press OK. The data can now be shown in normalized mode with this button. I will now unhide the data channel and hide the reference channel from the view. To define bands in the data channel, I select Bands, Search Data Bands. If you are not satisfied with the band search settings, the Search Bands dialog can be called again. In the main window, all entries now have experimental data for all newly created fingerprint types. Clicking on the colored dot will show the respective curve. This ends this video. Please tune in to our other videos where more functionality is explained.